Hello and welcome. My name is Søren Clemensen. In this How Do I video, we will show you how to add a table and a page in an extension for Dynamics 365 Business Central. To do this, we will create a table in step 1, then we will create the card page belonging to the table in step 2 and 3, we will create a list page, and finally we will make it searchable in the application. Now let's get started. First we're going to create a table. We're going to create a new file to host the table code. We're going to use a snippet to create the table, in this case 50,100. We're going to call it book. Field 1 is going to become number, and that's a code 20 field. We're going to caption the field number. And then we're going to create a second field, field 2, which is the title of the book. That's a text 50 field. Again, we're going to give it a caption, title. And we're going to add 5 more fields quickly here: author, hardcover, and page count. We're going to caption the table itself. And that's it. Now we have a table. The next thing we're going to do is we're going to create another file, this time for the list page. We're going to use a snippet for page. In this case, we need to choose the one that's two for pages here, and we need to choose the one for list. 50,100, and we're going to call it book list. The source table of this one is of course book that we just created, and we can start filling in some fields here. We will fill in number and title as the two fields to be displayed on the list. Once we have filled in number here, we have set the application area like everywhere else to all. And then we have to add the title. And again, we have to set the application area to all, so we make sure it shows up, the field shows up in all application areas. Now we have to set the caption on the page itself. What's book list in this case? Then we have to set the page itself non-editable. It's a list page after all. And then we set the use category to list. This makes it searchable in the without being on the role center. And of course we set the application area to all, so it shows up everywhere. Next thing we need to do is make a book card page, so a card for the list. We again use a snippet. This time we choose the card page snippet. We call it 50,101 book card. Leave it as a card page. And source table is book. Then we take the first group here, we call it general, and change the field to number. And we set the application area to all. Then we add the title field to the card page. And again, we have to set the application area to all. Now we're going to create a second group. This one we're going to call detail or details. So here we'll add the field author with application area all in our case. And now we have added the remaining fields. So of course we have to go and set a caption on the group, which was details. We have to do the same on the first group, which was general. Then we have to set some caption on the card itself. We'll call it book card. And we have to fix a little error here. We have to put details onto the group. So it's named. And then we have to jump to the list and identify the card page ID so we know which card page that needs to be opened. Now let's run the application, search for the book list. The book list will be found here. We can see there's an empty list of books. We can click new and we can add a book to the list. Just give it a number, give it a title, my book, go down, add an author. In this case, I'll say I've made it, and hardcover. And then we can put in page count. And the book has been entered into the book card. And if we close the book card, you'll see it's listed now on the list of books.
Now let's summarize what we did. First thing we did was we created a table. Then we created a card page. And we created a list page, made sure the card page was named on the list page. Last but not least, we made the list page searchable so we can find it after we have installed the extension or app. If you want to know more about how to create apps for Dynamics 365 Business Central, you can go to aka.ms/businesscentralapps for more information. I hope you enjoyed the video and I hope to see you back another time.